Taking a prestigious job with the Department for Internal Affairs might make you sound like a spy. But Ben Brown is an open book. The author and poet has been appointed New Zealand's inaugural Te Awhiritō Reading Ambassador. It's Ben's job to promote reading to children and young people. I visited him at home in Lyttelton and asked him about the simple magic of stories.
On the main drag in Lyttelton, just above the bakery, is a view of a busy port, 1,000 logs and 1,000 stories.
When Scott's first voyage to Antarctica arrived here in the early hours of 1900, whenever it was, he sent his young ensign up to the office to see if there's any telegrams from home. That fellow was Ernest Shackleton.
The Ernest Shackleton.
He would have been, I don't know, 1920 then.
That telegraph
office, right there, that door.
Ben Brown is a man who loves stories.
I'm somewhere else when I read. The more I can get into a good read, the further and further away everything else becomes. And I'm just kind of there, with my words, building the picture in my head.
And isn't that one of life's most magical little pleasures? The immersion, the escape, the page pinched between two fingers, the tension of a paperback spine.
How do we remember people close to us? You know, we talk about them as stories. When we think about our own lives and how we go about things, we tend to think of them as stories. We don't just connect together a whole bunch of events and that was my day. Stories are puzzles and conundrums and enigmas.
And it's Ben Brown's mission to try and bottle the enigma.
I've been a farmer, I've been a labourer, I've been a driver, I've been a barman, a bouncer, a hustler, I've been an artist, a tutor, a publisher, a gardener. I was a soldier for 8 weeks. That didn't work out. Drifting in morphine for days.
What did work out was writing.
I've always written. I've written ever since I can remember. It's been, you know, I used to carry around a little notebook, and my dirty little secret was writing poetry when I was a kid, and I never gave a stuff that it wasn't cool or anything else. I don't care. But I didn't actually come to reading until relatively late, because I grew up in the Motueka Valley on a farm by a river. It was a beautiful place. I had heaps to do, and reading just to me seemed to be time-consuming when I could be doing other things. My father, on the other hand, he was a voracious reader. He always had 2 or 3 books on the go, and he was trying to get me to read this particular book. Have you read it yet? Have you read it yet? He ragged on me for days and days and days. Have you read it yet? No. Read it? No. And he was walking past my bedroom door, and I was sulking in my room, and he said, have you read it yet? No. And he threw it at me. Hardcover volume. Tom Sawyer. Bang! Smacked me on the head. He said, read it. So I read it. Still remember the opening sequence, you know. Tom, no answer. Tom, no answer. What's going with that boy? Tom, no answer. And I loved it. I loved it because it was about a boy and his mate who lived on a river and bunked off school and avoided work as much as they could and went sailing down the way on rafts, and that was me and my mate. In the Motueka Valley in 1972.
Have you read South?
Yeah.
50 years on, Ben Brown has moved from a river to a port just around the corner from a library.
I'm guessing you're on a first-name basis.
Yep.
He's still enchanted by a good yarn.
It's not even just stories, it's words, you know. It's words in a certain assemblage. That's what makes a story, as opposed to a shopping list or a recipe or a bunch of abstract ramblings. Words are fascinating. The etymology that's involved, the history, the geography that's covered, especially in the English language, and in Māori, come to that, you know. I mean, Māori is a living language, so it grows according to its context and its needs and its requirements. Yeah. Always makes me laugh, those buggers. Oh, Māori never had a name for computer, before we can, and neither did you. So, you know.
And don't you think the Māori word for computer is a great...
Rorohiko!
Electric brain.
That's great, eh? Māori have an instinctive understanding of the power of a story. You know, so, I mean, pretty much everything that's of meaning in the Māori kind of cosmology comes in the form of a story. You know, your whakapapa, your pūrākau, those kinds of things, you know. They're all pakiwaitara, they're all stories. It's quite interesting to me that in the 19th century, for a long period there, Māori were more literate than the Pākehā settlers who were coming here. And then it just sort of got to about the late 1800s, and then it stopped. They no longer trusted it. If there's one thing I could do, it would be to say to some of those apparently disadvantaged Māori communities, if they are turning away or still shying away from literature and literacy. Just, you know, get with the tupuna, man.
It's the telling of the story.
How do you sell the magic of stories? Ben Brown says all he can do is speak to his own experience. An adventure, an escape, a completely different world is only ever a page away.